Hello, and welcome. I'm Xander, and this is Call of Chernobyl, and I have this pause because I just want to say something, talk about some things first. First of all, the reason why I'm paused instead of just standing there talking is because there's a chance combat may engage upon me exiting this. That said, I've installed the mod that increases the damage values for the S.T.A.L.K.E.R weapons. I think it's in general, but it's designed to make that one increased as well, which is what I'm using. I've pretty much edited the files as much as I could to remove the item soup thing as much as I possibly could without actually removing it, because I can't, because the game crashes while all references of it still really exist. So like that shitpost item that I left in that one stash, that's preventing me from removing the mod. Mostly just that and maybe a few other, like, yeah, I should have removed it and threw it on the ground somewhere, sold it to a vendor, I don't know. I should have gotten rid of it, and I probably could have removed the add-on at that point. But since I can't, I've removed, it should no longer spawn, it may be currently on the enemies. That said, I had to do some DDS file editing in order to, I wanted to revert some of the textures, like the ammo and things. I undid all of its vendor edits, so I have the STCOP edits back in, so, and all of that stuff. That said, I have a hilarious amount of money, but I have plans on dealing with that later. Like, I'm just gonna intentionally dump it. I've attempted to increase the flashlight distance, which I think I succeeded on. Because I undid a lot of its stuff, our max weight is up. But I figured that increasing the damage should make that better. I also purchased a screen helmet. Oh, so, there we go. Got a helmet. There's no night vision in this helmet. And it does provide a little bit of protection. But overall, it's mostly designed for anomalies. Which, remember how I said I installed deadly anomalies with misery values, but it didn't seem like it? Yeah. Item soup was... or I think it was item soup or something. It was being overwritten. Oh god. Okay. At least I know the damage values are in and functioning. Okay. Good. Since I'm in closer range, I'm actually going to detach the scope, put the holo sight on. The only downside is the holo sights in this mod are a bit buggy. Where was he? Okay. He killed me as fast as I was expecting. But I was expecting more when I shot him. You know what? Let's continue with the pistol. Let's try the pistol. Okay. Fair enough. Heavily armored military dude. I am going to be a bit more safe scummy now. Enemies may still spawn with the items on them. Oh god. If that's the case, I'm going to leave them on the corpse and the game should auto-delete them for me. Bandages, ammo. Okay, yeah, I was wondering if this is gonna be an issue. I hadn't fixed it yet. So he still has the chocolate bar, but the vodka is still fine. At least it should be. I heard the noises. I just assumed that he wouldn't get a chance to shoot at me, which I was thankfully right. Detached scope. Did that end up being... of course, I just bought that, and now it provides it to me. So I can fix the ammo thing, I'm not worried about that. We can deal with it for now. Just a note of that. Did I... no, I left it on the corpse, good. They should no longer spawn with it. I believe these enemies have them because I'd already been past here once with the mod enabled. so that should be good. Stairs down. But, yeah, I need to deal with the money value at some point. And I have a plan for that, but it's kind of irrelevant. Because there's no store here. Well, it is a stash. I don't know if I saved, but I'm gonna save anyhow. Did I finally get rid of everybody? Okay. Looks mostly safe. Famous last words. Okay. So I can actually sprint more now, so that's another big thing for me. I was thinking about that, but that jumping, that might be a bad idea. So, we're headed to the lab. Which lab is this? X18. I don't know if I need to do these in any specific order. I'm hoping I don't. This looks like we're possibly about to hit the door to it. Okay, cool. Hopefully there won't be any crashes. I've also done some editing of the clear sky units thing to actually make it function as I had intended. So if you look now, there's no enemies listed, but there's friendlies. Whoa. I think I have the helmet on. I do have the helmet on, right? No, I don't. Do now. Check out the corpse of the dead guy. He's a loner who's experienced. Okay. I don't like the sound of that. There is a poltergeist somewhere. It's the only thing that could really be throwing the boxes around. Well, better. Bure, I suppose. Snork. I am curious as to how much damage this will do to a snork. Nice. Okay, fair enough. Looks like I didn't get in a headshot that time, so he didn't drop as quickly. That's fair. Excellent, colleague. I'm glad that you've received second level access. At last, you'll finally find out what goes on in our laboratory. Your access code is 1243, Chief's Laboratory X18. Okay, 1243. Ain't he rad? There's your drink. Grenades. Oh, speaking of grenades, a lot of those grenades I've been picking up, the Vog 5 grenades, they actually come off of this. I don't know how to ready the grenade launcher, though. I've never actually really used them. V. Okay. Cool. Okay. That's useful. I just decided that you never know when it could come in handy, and I can actually sort of afford to carry them around now. So that would be a good idea. That said, I do not need a scope on this. That will use this one, Cobra Sight. There we go. You know what? Ooh. Is it down? Ow. Yeah, there we go. That's a much deadlier anomaly. Which is what I was after. 1, 2, 4, 3. Nice. This actually means that I need to be careful because my health kits can run out pretty easily, too. Oh god, it's upset with me. Guys, are there? Ow. I still left the chocolate because it was the only source of food I still had on me. There's still a poltergeist somewhere. Whatever. Worry about him later. Another locked door. Okay. What? Excuse me? Okay, so now that we know what's down here, I'm actually just gonna swap to this. Attach scope, put on the holo sight. I don't have a whole lot of ammo for this at the moment. I don't know how I lost so much, but... Die already, please. Stand there to change my game mode, and apparently... Oh, wait, are those tanks flammable? It That's a good question I need to check out, actually. Perhaps not. Ow. Ow. Stop throwing stuff at me, please. Guys, good. I know they're here somewhere. Ow. Okay. Only taking a little bit of damage so far. Oops. Wait. Oh god, I've lost myself. Shimmering effect is actually a bit easier to see. My light off. Ow. Okay, poltergeists are officially the worst. Okay, that's a pseudo-giant. I'm going back up here. I guess I'm gonna have to stop playing with the poltergeist. Ah! Or at least try to, but apparently they're gonna keep throwing crap at me. There's still like two or three poltergeists. That's one. That's, I think, three so far. There's two or three I've killed. Four. Why you have to be Crash? I don't understand why it crashed. Like, that was a standard X-ray crash. That wasn't like a CTD because something's missing. That was just, it didn't like what happened, and so it exploded. The pseudo giants annoy me so much, though, because it just, they're giant bullet sponges, really. With this for the moment. It did it again. Why? Pretty sure it's not creating a crash log. Well, I was gonna go check, but then it loaded up again. I'm trying to think if there's anything I could have done that would cause that, but it just, if there was an actual crash log, which I'll have to check this next time it crashes, but if there's an actual crash log, I'll be able to figure out if there's some reason why it's doing it, but I literally think it's just sort of an engine explosion problem, more or less. What I mean by that is all the stuff that he's exploding at once. I think if I were to, like, quickly destroy a good chunk of these boxes myself. I think that'll cut down on the problem. Though that was definitely a massive crash. Yeah, because the X-ray log is empty. Like, it's just straight up empty. I don't know what the best way to kill a pseudo giant is. I actually don't know. Because they're like giant bullet sponges. And clearly it's causing me a massive crash problem. Every other time I've killed them, I've dropped like an entire mag of AR ammo and like 2 to 3 mags of pistol ammo at them, and I'm not entirely sure if I can kill him before he crashes the game. Try pumping some hydro shock rounds into him since I don't have a whole lot anyhow. What? When did I pick up AKs? Speaking of AKs, you know what? Good idea. Oh. I didn't have one loaded. Whoops. Is he dead? Cool. Bandage. Big problems is there's a lot of boxes in here. Pretty sure these aren't destructible. Okay. Well, managed to get through the crashing problem by annihilating it. Pseudo-giant eyes and hands. Oh, I see, that's an air vent. That's putting out hot air. Fun times. Well, let's... Oh god, I'm lost. Oh. Is that another one of that? Yes, it is another wrenched. Okay. Wait, what? Is that fireball? Oh wow, it adds armor? If only I had a second slot to pair it with my radiation down artifact. Okay, that looked like some 9x18 ammo. I need to look a little bit harder for corpse of some kind or something. Does this do anything? No. Oh! Hello. I can get an achievement with that. So I'm gonna hold on to it. There's an achievement, which actually, what it does, I looked into them to figure out what they did, because there is one that is curious how you get, which it involves getting 1,000,000 rubles. I don't think it once, I think it's lifetime. But it basically makes things like the Sparog detector and the Velas detectors more common. By more common, I mean for purchase on scientists. And it's more, it's all rare items, it's not just those, but... Those are the big ones that come to mind for me. Am I an idiot? Like, is that door open already or something? Nope. That's not the code. Ugh, they're wrecking my armor. Okay, so I need to find, like, a paper, or... Jerk. Come back here, jerk. I'm not done with you. Ow. Die! Holy cow! Excuse me? Ow. not sure I can get through there. I feel like I have to, though. Wait, how did I get through here last time? I'm very confused. Yeah, I don't see a way through there, even with my suit. Seeing anything. This is where a Call of Pripyat playthrough would have helped. Actually, no, this one would have been Shadow of Chernobyl, I assume. Okay, yeah, there's more boxes up there. Do I have to go up there? Is there enough room? Oh, there is. Oh. And then I can fall off like an idiot. Let's not get in a hurry now. Go that way? No, but this way looks like it's easier. Is that a dead guy? It's definitely bones. What a horrible place to die. Okay, so this raises questions. The only way left I see to go is through there. There's clearly still... Well, this feels like a side field, but I don't know... Is it the corpses of the ones I killed before? Confused. I was in here, wasn't I? So I got to that box, and there was nothing in it. This looks like chemical. I'm gonna take some radio tech, or sorry, antidote. Yeah, it's a box, but I can't access it. Ah, screw it, might as well just reload that. I'm actually starting to run out of ideas. The other side of the fire. Okay. I keep thinking it should be down where the pseudo-giant was, but I don't know. I just haven't seen anything. This seems really weird to me. Is it like hiding in the very back confines? Is it up there and I missed it? Maybe. Guess I'll go take a check. I have an RPG in case of emergencies. Here's what I don't get, is I feel like these boxes should be able to be opened. And that's clearly designed for a purpose. I'm really confused right now. I didn't accidentally find it, did I? Well, still the previous one, which I already tried. It's going on for a little bit, but I'm deeply confused right now, so. It's not like inside of one of these, is it? I feel like another check of up here is in order. Now this way looked like it led it to a dead end last time. But doesn't hurt to check. I can't jump that. Grenade. Change the fact that I'm extremely confused right now. Why am I so bad at finding this? Do I need to go check the upstairs or something? Did I come down too soon? The only thing I can think of. I was in a hurry because of the poltergeists, but it seems like they were down here, so. No, I was already in here, I believe. And a changed ammo because of my reload habit. Okay, I'm wearing the helmet. Those are the snorks. That's the first dead guy. I don't understand where I'm supposed to go. The stairs I came down, right? Yes. I checked that body. It came from over there. Still on the quest, so I'm not completely insane. I'm getting an anomaly reading, or an artifact reading. Which is still in an unknown location. I am so confused right now. Can I get up into the vent system? See, I don't know why, but I thought there was supposed to be, like, a corpse there. Or down here somewhere. Pretty sure I checked, like, every inch of this place. Get one more good look over, I suppose. Casual stroll. Okay. About what I expected from there. Is there anything you can safely drop? No. Not really. Snark feet, maybe? I don't really want to get rid of the RPG launcher. Because I want to hit a helicopter with it. Okay, that's the short version. anomaly there. Oh. I was expecting to have some sort of forward momentum. Take off the helmet though, because it's annoying me. Hopefully these sound effects aren't too loud. Just because I'm impatient. I wish to sprint more. You know what? I'm not afraid to save scum this. An emission recently occurred in the zone. There we go. That was as pointless as I expected. Stop now. And what purpose does this serve? So what I can see, the answer is none. Wow. I don't know if you saw that. But I realized why I couldn't find the corpse. You know what? I don't even care. I deserved that fall damage. It was next to the body the whole time. You know what? I've been picking up quite a bit of 9x18 ammo. 9x19 ammo. Might as well take it just in case. Okay, so what message do we get for that? Dear colleague, I may remind you that starting tomorrow you will attend to the container in the central laboratory room. You must inspect the container every 2 hours. Report everything directly to me. The code for the central laboratory room is 9524. This is going to be a little long, so what I'm going to do, it's already long, so I'm going to be stopping it. We're going to get to the door. I'm going to save there. And this, so we're calling it for now. So, yeah, I'm gonna call this good, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day.